Let's suppose I have a function, say f of x, which is defined in an interval 0 to L. Okay. What I want is, I want to get an equivalent series which gives me the value of this function at each point between 0 and L and which contains only cosine terms. Okay. So, I am looking for an infinite series of cosine terms that is equivalent to this function between 0 to L. Okay. Let us see how we are going to find that series. Let's just suppose that my function is like this. Okay. It's a general function. I'm just assuming its graph is like this. It could be anything. Okay. So, what I'm saying is, between 0 to L, my function is like this. What I am going to do now is, I am just going to take a reflection of this function along y-axis. Okay. So, let's suppose it's something like this. Okay. Now, if you look at this function, if you have a point x, then over here you are going to have a point minus x. Okay. And if over here you have a y, then since it is a reflection, over here also you will have the value of this function as y. Okay, so if you look at this function between 0 to, or rather between minus L to plus L, let's call this function as capital F of x. Then if you look at capital F of x, which is essentially this function, then it is a even function, right? Because your capital F of minus x is equal to capital F of x, okay? Capital F of minus x is equal to capital F of x. Therefore, your F of x is even, okay? And now, if I were to get the Fourier series of this even function between minus L to L, I know that it's going to have only cos terms because bn is equal to 0 in that case. Okay. Therefore, your Fourier series for fx in minus L to L is equal to what? It is equal to a0 by 2 plus summation n is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by L. Okay. Now, everywhere where your function is continuous, your fx is given by the sum of your Fourier series. Okay. So, between minus L to 0, it is equal to sum of your Fourier series, and same is the case between 0 to L. Okay. Just look over here. Your fx in 0 to L is also equal to the sum of your Fourier series, which is this guy. N is equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x by L. But the point is, fx between 0 to L is your this thing, which is your small fx. Okay, so essentially what you have got is, you have represented your small fx between 0 to L as a series containing only cos terms. Okay, and this is known as half range Fourier series or half range cos Fourier series. Okay, cos series. Over here, what is your a0? Your a0 is going to be 2 upon L integration 0 to L capital fx dx. Okay. And between 0 to L, what is your capital fx? It is your small fx. So, essentially, your half range cos series a0